now that we have the business now begins. Now we know who's here. We gather today with our candidates for Bexar County Commissioner Precinct 1 and Texas State Representative District 118 to learn from them on where they stand on the issues that directly impact our community and our lives. Our future, safety, and quality of life will surely be impacted by how they choose to represent our area. We are here tonight to show our candidates for office that this community is extremely concerned about what happens in the south part of the city and of the county. We are fed up with taking a back seat to our neighbors to the north. We want a fair day's pay for a fair day's work. We want to partner with our elected officials to build parks, community centers, and recreational facilities to promote healthy living for our citizens. We want them to stop the abuse created by greedy financial institutions who are eager to take advantage of our friends through deceitful payday loans. We need them to help us improve our educational system by increasing the funding of our schools and stop placing the burden on our local school districts. Our young people hold the key to our future, and they deserve better schools and a better education. We need their support on workforce training to provide meaningful opportunities to our citizens so they can break the cycle of poverty that unfortunately can extend from generation to generation. We want to show our political candidates that we need to work together and begin a dialogue so that we can improve the quality of life in the South Side. Candidates, tonight we stand together as a community to be heard and to get your commitments to work with us.
Thank you, Mr. Martinez. Thank you for explaining why we're here tonight. Now we will hear stories from individuals in our communities regarding the issues we are presenting to these candidates and for which we are asking for their support. The first story we will hear will be on the payday lending, and Father Frank Macias will be speaking about payday lending.
When I was pastor, and we had a lady that cooked for us, se llamaba Selma. She was 85 years old and she had Alzheimer's. And actually, nosotros cocinábamos por ella. You see, we actually did cooking for her. We actually had her come into the rectory to take care of her because she had Alzheimer's. Cada viernes se iba ella y caminaba por el centro. Y el centro era González, Texas, by the way. Entonces, estaba lloviendo un viernes. It was raining on a Friday. And I followed her. I said, I wonder where Selma is going. Her house is the other direction. La seguí, entró una oficina donde era un lugar de préstamos. It was a lending place. And I said, ¿qué está haciendo allí? Entré yo. I entered there and I said, excuse me, but what are you doing here, Selma? Dijo, pues me mandaron una carta y me dijeron que tenían $100 para mí. They sent her a letter and said, you have $100 here at this office. Pues vine y me dieron los $100. So I came and they gave me the $100. And I said, how long ago was that at Selma? Dice, oh, hace como dos o tres años. Y dije yo, ¿y qué he pagado? Pues yo Siempre vengo, I always come here, that was about 3 years ago, and I give them $30 a week. Por $100. Entre yo, le dije yo, let me see that folder that you have on this lady here. She's sick, she has Alzheimer's. And the manager gave me the folder, and I saw that she had paid over $2,000, $2,000, on a $100 loan, because she would pay late. She would receive letters that would say that if she doesn't go there and pay there, that they were going to give the information to the sheriff. Pobrecita, estaba atormentada. And she was sick. And I took the folder from him. I said, I'm going to take this folder. And you can call the sheriff, you can call anybody that you want to call. But I'm taking her, and she's never going to come in here again. And their face were white. You know, and I guess maybe he could have shot me, you know. But my brothers and sisters, I thought that was just one case. Yo estaba bajo la impresión que nomás era mi Selma. But it's not. It is a lot of people. And here in San Antonio, every time I pass by these places that you leave your car title there and then you end up paying all that money, it's crimen. It's crimen. It's a crime. So hopefully we'll have people that will support the honesty and the goodness of the South Side, because you know what, most of them are located in this area. No más porque somos pobres, just because we're poor. But we pray then that our eyes are open to that reality. Amen?
Amen.
The next story we will hear will be concerning the Highland Oaks issue. And for that, we have Zanette Gutierrez, and she's from El Carmen, and from the Highland Oaks area. Zanette.
My name is Zanette de la Fuente. I'm a member of Lady of Mount Carmel Catholic Church and Bocas, the newest member of COPS Metro. For the last 15 years, I have been a homeowner in the Highland Oaks subdivision, a community in the far south side of Bexar County, outside city limits, that has no paved streets, no sidewalks, no lights, no street signs. The roads are so bad that school buses don't go in, and we just lost trash collection services because vehicles get stuck in the sand. This past February, my six-year-old daughter was making hot cocoa at home and spilled it all over herself. She suffered second-degree burns to her abdomen and right thigh. I quickly realized her injuries were serious, so I called 911. The dispatcher was on the phone with me as I held my daughter, who was screaming and shaking in pain. He was giving me instructions on what to do. At the same time, was asking me what my street looked like, what was my cross street, what was near my house, and asked me if someone can stand outside my house because the emergency responders could not find my home. As a nurse, I know that ambulances are expected to arrive in less than 9 minutes from the time they are dispatched. In my daughter's case, it took over 25 minutes. Why? Because the things have not changed in Highland Oaks in the last 15 years. But we have had enough. Last summer, we started to learn from COPS Metro how to organize ourselves. We still don't have our paved roads, but last month, the county approved a plan to invest $4.4 million over 2 years to pave all of Highland Oaks. But this plan is not in the budget yet. We won't let up until this plan is included in the budget and our streets are paved.
Thank you, Asunet. The next story we will hear will be from Project Quest, and we have Sonia Sedna.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Sonia Sedna. I am a participant of Project Quest and a nursing student at San Antonio College. I am a level 4 student, pending graduation December 2016. Thank you. When I get my first job as an RN, I will be earning about $52,000, having gone from 25 to 52,000. I am here to tell you about why Project Quest is important to this community. At this time, I would like to share a quote that I have in my room. I see it and read it every day. If one were sufficiently trained and self-confident, if one were willing to labor with one's hands and one's mind, one could have what has come today to be called the American dream. I believe that quote was written by Benjamin Franklin. Having lost both parents at a young age, that dream has been kind of hard for me to reach. But with the help of Project Quest, it has been much easier for me to find that dream. They have been a great blessing. They have helped me purchase books, which they're not cheap. They're about over $1,000. They've helped me pay for uniforms, medical equipment. They've even given us gas cards sometimes. Because of Project Quest, I've been able to concentrate on my schoolwork rather than worry about how to pay for tuition and books. I am here to tell you that the students of Project Quest are willing to labor with their hands and their mind. We ask for your support. We need Project Quest. Project Quest needs you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sonia. It was beautiful. We will have now, Mr. Martinez is going to be introducing the candidates and going over the candidates, for the rules for the candidates' questions.
Before we move on to the next part, I'd like to go ahead and introduce the candidates we have with us tonight. For State Representative District 118, we have Representative John Lujan and Tomas Uresti. For County Commissioner Precinct 1, we have John V. Garza and Gabriel Lara. I would like to just reiterate that all the candidates met with COPS Metro leaders beforehand, and they have all agreed to follow the rules. Now, I want to invite Mr. Cruz and Mrs. Martinez, who will be asking the questions.
Please stand, Mr. Lujan.
Yes, sir.
And Mr. Oreste. My name is Robert Cruz, a leader with COPSA Metro and a member of St. Leo the Great Catholic Church. The issues and questions I will be asking the candidates and the representative have emerged from meetings and conversations within our community. And here's the first question. It deals with education. This year, the Texas State Supreme Court ruled that the funding formula is unequal, but that it is not unconstitutional. The state legislature, instead of acting to improve education funding in the state, it has cut funds for education. Most recently, they are proposing restricting money for special education. We are here to change that. Do you commit to raise additional state revenue for public schools, especially those that have large populations of students or economically disadvantaged and English language learners, or to move us toward universal pre-K education in Texas and to cover the expense of the SAT or ACT for every high school student? On payday lending, every day, unscrupulous lenders rob families of their hard-earned wages through payday and title loans. They make families poor, yet say they offer a much-needed service to deal with this issue. If elected, will you support a law that explicitly makes threats of criminal charges for non-payment of payday or auto titled Illegal. Will you support a law mandating Spanish language disclosure on all payday and title loan contracts and paperwork? Will you support urging the state to adopt the unified ordinance on payday lending that many cities have passed and to respect the right of municipalities to enact those consumer protections? If elected, do you support a law that will prevent the industry's attempt to raise the rates that can be changed for consumer loans to lengthen the loan term allowable from the current 180 days to a longer term, and to add secondary products such as life insurance to loan transactions? Another issue. So far, with the state doing nothing on payday lending, cities like San Antonio have bravely stepped forward to protect their residents. But now Texas wants to change that, even take that away from us and return to the wild west of usurious lending. Will you support the right of all cities and counties to raise tax revenue without interference? Do you support upholding cities' right to regulate their local issues by passing ordinances? On Project Quest, for 25 years, Project Quest has proven to be one of the nation's leading workforce development programs. In fact, last Monday, the executive director, Sister Pearl Cesar, was invited again to the White House to meet with the Secretary of Labor to showcase its success in developing a well-trained workforce to earn living wages with economically disadvantaged populations. This is a program worth fighting for. Do you support maintaining the current level of state funding through the Adult Career Education, or ACE, fund to continue supporting the successful work of Project Quest here in San Antonio and throughout the state? On Medicaid, we hear stories about citizens being turned away from emergency rooms because they don't have health insurance. That people continue suffering without care is a moral stance that the state has taken. But it does not have to be that way. We have an option. Do you support expanding Medicaid in Texas? On the first issue on education, do you answer yes or no, Representative Devine?
I answer yes.
On payday lending, what is your answer, yes or no?
100% yes.
On local control to the cities, do you answer yes or no?
Yes.
On Project Quest, yes or no?
Oh, definite yes.
And finally, on Medicaid, yes or no?
Yes.
Have to repeat the questions. It's yes, 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 and yes.
Now, Representative Levin, you have 2 minutes to give any response to any of the issues that we covered.
Okay. Give me a couple of tears. Okay, first of all, thank you for inviting us here. I'm the state representative right now, and I'm just blessed to be here. And I want to tell you, this is very, very important. The payday lending one really bothers me because it's predatory, especially on the minorities, especially in our community. That really bothers me. What bothers me the most is because it's affecting, and it's not, I can't believe that we don't have it in Spanish also. That has to be in there. We need to put laws in there to protect our citizens. That's 100%. Second one that I do want to comment on was Ms. De La Fuente was talking about at Highland Oaks. I've been there before. I drove with them and we went through Highland Oaks. I drove there and I made them stop. It was raining. We had to use four wheel. I wouldn't take my car there. I'd get stuck. We went over there and I said, how does a fire truck come to this house? I'm a retired firefighter. I was a firefighter for 25 years. I was a police officer for 6 years. I said, how does a police come here? How does a fire come? And they said they don't come here. They just can't. That's a shame. This is America. This is the United States. That should not happen. Why our leadership has allowed that to happen really, really shocks me. That should not happen. Another one is Project Quest. I'm going to be honest with you. I didn't know much about Project Quest until you enlightened me and we looked at it. Then I was reading all the success stories, and that's what I'm about. That's what prompted me to run for office, because I know we can break cycles of poverty by teaching technology, the high-paying jobs of tomorrow. I started a company in 1999, the three of us, and today we're a little over 400 employees. We're breaking cycles of poverty. We've done that through my company, helping kids in our community, and it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. These things are very important. Am I done with my time? Okay, and then the last one is the education. That's what prompted me to run. Because of the education, we need to fund it better. I don't like us being disadvantaged out here. Everything goes wrong to education. Who wants to bring companies in here if you don't have a good school board and a good system? You know, we have failing schools. We gotta fix that. We have to fix that. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
I think most of you know that I've been sitting on the Hartnell School Board for right at 13 years, and education has been key. It's been my life. I've given blood, sweat, and tears into education. We are sitting in the number one school district that was ranked as the number one school district in the entire state of Texas. We have right now what is going, of course, the funding is there, and there's more funding needed, and yes, I will definitely support it. We have a STEM high school here in Hartnell that me and my colleagues were able to put together. That when you graduate from Hartnell STEM High School, you will leave with a high school diploma in one hand and an associate's degree in the other. We have cosmetology certificates. We have health careers high schools here in Hartnell. We have the highest technology and automotive technology here in Hartnell. We have the best of the best. So we are breaking the cycles of poverty right here in Hartnell, right here. And we're bringing people from South Santa and from South Side, from the entire, all the different districts want to come to Hartnell. That's why everybody wants to be here. So yes, I'm definitely going to push for more monies for the public system, because right now we're receiving the least amount of money in the average school district. We're in the lower ranking. We receive about $7,500 per child versus other school districts that receive $12,500 per child. And that's not right. And it's up to the legislatures to make that change once and for all.
What was the second one? I'm sorry.
Payday lending is a joke. They need to be shut down. They don't need to be regulated. They need to be just totally shut down. The average payday loan takes 800% to pay back. But it's not just the payday loan companies. There are markets here. There are other companies here in San Antonio and throughout the state of Texas that will sell you life insurance, health insurance, disability insurance. Would you believe they sell you unemployment insurance when you buy a piece of furniture from them? It's not just the payday loan companies. Those are one of them. But there's a lot more than that. Project Quest. I'm sorry.
Good afternoon. My name is Molly Martinez. I am from Our Lady of Mount Carmel in Bocas. Let me tell you what Bocas is all about. It stands for Bear Organized Community Area South, and that is La Voz de la Gente. Commissioner Rodriguez was invited. He was invited by Cops Metro, but he's not here. And we don't know why, okay? So I thank Mr. John Garza, Mr. Gekulu Lara, thank you so much for being here with us. And so this is the questions. This year, Bexar County Commissioners Court approved $750,000 to begin the study for Highland Oaks. However, this is just the beginning. Do you commit to support over the next 2 years the $4.4 million necessary to pave the Highland Oaks subdivision? Many of our residents do not have a place to bring their children for educational enrichment classes, such as Boys and Girls Club or other extracurricular activities. We need a space for our families, our community in South Bear County. Do you commit to support and fund a community center at the Mission Soccer Complex for South Bear County next year? This year, the Commissioner's Corps led the way again in fighting for paying his workers a dignified wage by passing a new budget with a minimum wage of $13.75 an hour, leaving out the conviction that public money should not be used to pay poverty wages. They even went a step further and raised the minimum wage for contract workers to $9.50 an hour. My sister was part of that. She was getting $7.25. And I know how much she had to work two jobs for that. We applaud them for their effort, but our work is not finished. This upcoming year, do you commit with COPS Metro leaders next year to raise the minimum wage to county employees to $14.50 an hour and to raise the wage floor set for contract workers to $10 an hour? Also, this year, the county raised their investment in Project Quest to $80,000, up from $50,000. Their work has continued to set the bar for quality workforce development. Will you work with COPS Metro leaders to raise the county's investment, Project Quest, to $150,000 next year? Mr. Garza.
Yes to Highland Oaks.
Community center for our community.
Yes.
Living wages.
Yes.
Project Quest.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. And I do have to point out that COPS Metro brought up the minimum wage. Okay, so that's one of the important things that we're doing here. Mr. Garza, you have 2 minutes.
Thank you for inviting me out. I want to talk first about the Highland Oaks. My record as state representative of District 117 is providing basic services and improving services to the outlying county area. So that would, of course, include roads, basic sewer systems, water. So I commit to expand those services, not only to Highland Oaks, but many of the areas, La Crosse, Sandy Oaks, there's many outlying areas that need basic services. The second, as far as facilities for the children, I believe, yes, that mission facility is there. It needs to be funded, but we also need the schools and other public entities to share in opening their facilities to the children in the outlying areas for sports, exercise, and other activities for the community. Also, as far as committing to you as a commissioner to make sure that there's efficiencies in every department, and those people that are working and working hard get that wage that can help them support their family. And last of all, Project Quest met with me in my office in Austin. Being here in San Antonio, Bexar County, I do commit to work with them and other organizations to increase higher education and training programs through Project Quest, but also other organizations and the school districts and other public entities. There's plenty of money out there, and with all the legacy projects that the county is involved in, spending millions and millions of dollars in parks and things that they can put name after their names, we need basic services, we need roads, we need sewer, we need medical and transportation in the outer county area to bring students to college classes, to emergency medical services out in the outlying county areas for emergencies like what happened to your daughter. there should be a clinic around the corner just like there is in the city. So these are commitments I've made in the past, and I will continue to represent you in the County Commissioner's Court. Thank you very much.
Thank you for inviting me back. I was here in the early 60s with Father Ebisch from CCD and Sister Agnes. It's been a while. On the Highland Oaks subdivision, my mom and I have traveled that neighborhood. She said it reminded her of the near Rio Bravo, where she used to live in Mexico. So it's just horrendous. It's a public safety issue, not just an issue about convenience. When you can't, I spent 34 years with the fire department. So if you can't get into a scene, it's an issue. So I definitely support getting that fixed. The community center, yes, but with some stipulations. And it's not just a community center, that it's also be used for perhaps looking after our kids for after school care programs, or education for diabetic training and other issues as such. Cops Metro, the raid. The minimum wage. It's not just a matter of dignity. It's just it's not just about getting out of government subsidizing help. It's about keeping good employees. They're having an issue with Bexar County where their turnover rate is just really high, especially in the detention center, where they're spending thousands of dollars to train their detention officers just for them to go and find another job. So that's definitely an issue. And the last one with Cops Metro, I visited with Sister Pearl about 2 months ago. I've seen the return of investment that they offer. It's phenomenal. So I definitely support Cops Metro with Project Quest and other programs. I remember back in high school, Sonia was popular back then. That's the other kind of programs I'd like to promote. That's where we need to be focusing on our children, not just projects in the downtown area. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Garza, and thank you, Mr. Lara.
Mrs. Mora?
I want to thank the candidates for being here tonight. I appreciate your presence. But I have one more question to ask you. Will you commit, if you're elected, will you meet with Cops Metro within the 2 weeks after being elected, and then quarterly thereafter?
Yes.
Do you have your commitment to meet with us? We do that when we have new candidates.
I'm going to sleep for 2 weeks. I do the day after.
We will give you time to rest. Thank you. Thank you very much. Mr. Cruz and Ms. Martinez will escort you all out of the hall as we move to the next part of our agenda. Thank you very much and good night. If you've been watching the news regarding the candidates who are to lead our nation, this election is different than any other election we have seen in our lifetime. Like never before, it is important that we all exercise our right to vote. We need to get our own families and our neighbors to go vote. It's up to us, the voters, to decide who will lead our nation. We do not tell you who to vote for. You make up your own mind as to who you want to vote for, but go vote. Your vote is your voice. Su voto es su voz. Early voting began today, as you know, October 24th, and it's gonna run through November the 4th. So it is best to vote early. By voting early, you will avoid the long lines that are expected to form on November the 8th, the actual election day. If the lines are long now for early voting, I heard today, can you imagine how it's going to be on November the 8th? So, but if you vote early, you can vote at any of the voting places listed on the schedule. You all have picked up a schedule of the voting places. Does everybody have one? Does everybody have one of these sheets that tells you where to go to vote? Todos tienen este papel donde tiene la lista de los lugares donde puede ir a votar. You can go to the mall, to the library. Here in the south side, you go to the Mission Library. Well, some of these are okay. You can go to Las Palmas Library on Castroville Road, Collins Garden Library, South Park Mall. That's where I go because I go shopping. South San ISD Administrative Building, Precinct 1 Satellite Office. It's the one where you pay your taxes, I believe, on Pleasant Road. Palo Alto College, Southside Administrative Building. So if you can get one of these papers, we have had them up there on the table to take with you. Pueden llevar este papel y está en español también, donde pueden ir a votar. No dejen de ir a votar. Don't wait too long. You have starts today and it'll run through November the 4th. Remember, when you go vote, we encourage you to not vote the party line. Don't just say, oh, I'm whatever party you want to choose. Because there are many important elections like the San Antonio ISD and the South San ISD elections, if you belong to those school districts, you will miss out on them if you go the party line. So you need to go race by race and make your choice all the way through. Your duty as a citizen does not stop at the party or the president. Instead, it requires us to vote all the way through the ballot. Vayan candidato por candidato, no vayan a votar nomás por el partido. Porque si lo hacen, entonces no alcanzan a votar por los otros elecciones de otros candidatos que son muy importantes de la ciudad, del condado.
Let us begin in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Loving Father, we thank you for bringing us together and keeping us together as your children, as a community. We ask you to guide our leaders. Help them know to bring us justice, to bring fairness to your community. We ask you to send your angels to watch over us and keep us safe as we leave here and go home. We ask this in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This meeting is adjourned. Thank you. Thank you for being here.